So you pay your interest as you go. So I emerge out of this fog. I remember the day I did it. It was funny. I didn't realize I was like in a fog until one day I'm like, we're out at Comerchex eating cabbage rolls. And all of a sudden I just shake, like I woke up. This is like, I woke up and I looked at her and go, oh my gosh, I've missed you. She goes, I've missed you too. Like before, like, cause you're just gone. And I'm like, where's my life at? Like, obviously I kept living and kept working. And I'm not sure how that happened, but I don't, it's just gone. So you build up that savings. Now the minute I come out of it, what do I gotta start doing? Building it back up, right? Because we have to have the resources to give. It's just that simple. If I don't have the money, I can't give it to you. So we've got this whole savings thing going on. And getting the sense of how this happens. What about mortgages? What are mortgages? Large amounts of money. Do we take mortgages on our loans? Or on our relationships?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. People always ask me if you can recover from cheating. Yes. You can. Your relationship can recover. However, you are taking a massive loan, massive mortgage at an incredibly high interest rate. Really high interest rate. If you're going to sign up for this, what do you have to know? You have to realize you have to work a million times harder. For how long? For a long time. And you still have to pay off your original. Like, so the loan is an addition to what you have to do to maintain the basic relationship. So you're working hard at just maintaining, right? But it's not, I have to pay all the other bills. But now I'm paying something. My mortgage takes up like half my income. So you got to realize you are signing that paperwork. But then people go, okay, it'll be a year. I actually had someone come to therapy about this. Chrissy, that happened a year ago. They need to just move on. I know, so you got it. I looked at him and said, move on. They go, Chrissy, how long do I have to pay for this?
Until you're done paying.
I said, well, as long as I have to pay Wells Fargo. A very long time. 30 years. Plan on 30 years, that's how long my mortgage is. So plan on paying that loan for 30 years. That's what you signed up for. Can you do it? Yes. But you better realize you're signing over a loan for 30 years. You know, 5 years from now, you're going to be all pissed off when they bring it up again. You don't get to be. You took out the mortgage. You paid the mortgage. And some people come to me and they're like, Chrissy, why do I have to still pay? Well, because you call Wells Fargo and tell them you're done paying for it. That's what taking out a mortgage is. That's why you say don't do it. Or try to avoid it, because that's really hard work. Can be done, yes. I think when people really understand what they're getting into, it can be done well, but very few people realize what they're signing when they get back at that relationship. Lies, big lies. You're taking out a mortgage, a serious problem at work. You'll be paying that forever. Now, here's a type of mortgage that I think is completely unfair. Do we give mortgages to people under the age of 18? No, why? Right, we don't expect them to be able to pay for that the rest of their life. Unfortunately, we take out mortgages with our parents when we're under the age of 18. One of the mortgages that I've seen almost universally is having a kid before age 21, which I think is kind of not fair, personally. So this person goes out and they get pregnant or they have a child and they're 18, 19, 20. Somehow they've taken out a mortgage with their parents. But that's the way it goes. So what's the deal with a mortgage? Right.
I'm sorry.
Well,
so,
the thing is,
just for you.
The truth is, they kind of do in some respects. Because here's the deal. I'm not going to just abandon you. Yes? But there's some kind of unfairness with that, too. Because the parents are assuming. They're letting you sign a loan that you didn't agree to. But you take out a mortgage. No problem. Actually, I took out some mortgages when I was 13. It had nothing to do with a baby. It had everything to do with being a pain in the ass 13-year-old. I'm kind of going, Dad, really? I was 13. I had a big mouth. But I took out a mortgage. Said the wrong thing. So, okay, you got a mortgage. It's no problem. Realize you have a mortgage. If you had a child as a teen, you have a mortgage probably with your family. Here's what you got to know. 5 years from now, you could be the best parent in the world ever, and what are you going to hear?
You got pregnant as a teen.
Right, they're going to keep bringing it up. My sister got pregnant when she was 19 with my oldest nephew, who is now a doctor, married with a child. My dad will still be like, well, you got pregnant. Yeah, no. Okay, so there is some of that is fair. If that happened and you have something, you know, you went to jail, you got a DWI, all those things, you're going to have to, it's going to take a while. And you're going to have to pay for a long time. But is there a point in time at which you call Wells Fargo and say, dude, I'm done paying?
Yeah.
Yeah. And I'm talking to my sister and I go, why are you? He's 25. You're done. Your lease is up. I look at my dad and go, you are never going to say that again. That we're done with that. That debt is paid. I did look at my dad and go, dad, I was 13. I'm done with that. I'm not paying for something when I was 13. Is that fair? Like, he's still holding responsible when I was 8. So you have parents that understand the nature of debt. There are some debts that you take on fairly. You go, yeah. And there's some debts you look at your parents and go, I wasn't of age. Or I didn't agree to it. Some people try to put it on you. My sister still tries to remind me how she raised me. She's like, I raised you. It's true, she did. But I was a child. Can you take out mortgages as a child? No. You get to, and I look at her, you don't, no, we don't get to do that. I don't have to pay back a debt for when I was a child. So understanding the concept of these mortgages and debt structure is really important because you really don't want to get yourself into some of these loans. Right? Now, if you've put mortgages on other people, we can see, are they fair? Right? I mean, sometimes we hold people accountable for things that just aren't fair. Like they were a kid or they made a mistake. There are things that we can just let people off the hook for and we can just choose to do it. Are there times with people that you're obligated to look at them and go, okay, debt paid, we're done? Usually, I mean, Wells Fargo will keep taking my money until I'm like, no, we're done. So we got this mortgage, we got the overdraft, what's credit?
Your account in the positive and your loans paid.
Yes, so it's basically, it's usually when they pull a credit report, what are they doing?
Evaluation.
Mm-hmm.
Your history.
They're actually evaluating my history with somebody else, aren't they?
Yep.
Okay. So I started off teaching at Woodbury. Right? Now, now there's like 10 campuses. So is it important to have good credit?
Yes.
Why? Here's the deal. I can call up Latham, which I did, and said, do you have any classes for me to teach? And he's going to look at me and say, sure. He doesn't even know me. I didn't know Joe before I went there. Why am I now going to have that option?
Because you have credit.
Because I have good credit. That does not happen automatically. There are many instructors that are not allowed to teach other campuses, right? They'll just say no. They'll be like, nope, sorry, I don't have any. That's just flat out the way it is. Do you have good credit? Well, credit comes in a number of different ways. One, credit's transferable. So, by the way, teachers talk about you. We don't mean to talk about you, but we'll sit down and be like, oh man, have you had Jacob in class? And yeah, I had him. And if someone asks me about you, you're gonna get one of two answers. I will never try to give you back credit, ever. I think it's wrong. But here's what you'll get. You go, yeah, I had him in class. Or you're gonna get, I totally had him, he's awesome, you're gonna love him, it's gonna be great. I have purposely tried not to give you bad credit, but what have I given you? Bad credit. So, suppose you go to the first day of class and you're not in the first day of class and you send your instructor an email. If I gave you as neutral credit as I can, which is bad credit, what's that teacher going to assume about you? Yeah, they're going to be like, oh, there he is, blowing stuff off, you know. If I've given you these positive marks, what are they going to think of you? Something must have happened. Are you okay? How can I help you? And this is subtle, but your credit, it transfers not only to other people, but in the workplace. Why am I interested in Verizon? You're from Verizon. Okay. I'm like, I should go into Verizon. Have no interest in going into Verizon. Why all of a sudden am I like, well, I should stop and talk to Verizon? Yeah, you gave Verizon good credit. When it occurred to me, I would have gone to Sprint. You gave them good credit. That credit transfers. I'm very careful who I give my credit to. Very, very careful. So I've recommended only a few people work here. But apparently they hired my aunt, which I didn't know about. And so my boss is like, oh, we interviewed your aunt and she's going to work here. Don't you think that's great? And I went, she's what? I go, I think it'll be good. This is my aunt. I really want to put my neck out there. But why not put my neck out there?
No.
Well, yeah, she's sort of crabby and she used to teach special ed and I just didn't see this going well. Right? It wasn't anything bad, but what it was is if I put my neck out there, then my credit's bad. Right? That goes from person to person to person to person. And it's so important to understand how credit works. If I piss off my sister, what has happened to my other relationships in my family?
I don't have bad credit.
This is what really sucks. I have pretty bad credit with my family. And it's only because my sister. Now I call it unfair banking. And what do you do when you work for a bank that's unfair? You stop working with the bank for a while. Right? Some of it is fair. Another question that students ask me most commonly when I first started teaching was, how do you trust somebody? Every class, I want to learn how to trust. I'm like, trust, that was not in my curriculum either. Right? How to trust people. I could give you all kinds of things about what it is, but how to do it. So I had to like think and come up with a solution for how do I trust somebody. I did come up with one because you challenged me to. You guys want to know what it is?
Sure.
You can trust everybody. So, what can you trust everybody with?
But everybody's going to end up making mistakes eventually.
Well, yeah, you can trust that. Here's what you can trust. First of all, have you guys ever heard that you're like in a brand new relationship and that person's like, you should trust me?
Yeah.
Yeah, should you?
No.
No, that's kind of dumb. You don't know me. I used to work with Juno Blink once. They're like, I don't trust you. I go, good. Why should you trust me? Because I'm here? How many adults have done you wrong? Right? So with trust, no, you shouldn't. Trust does not descend from the heavens. We're in a relationship, therefore you trust me. Does that even make sense? I learned that how I figured out what I thought about trust is I was actually in a therapy session with a guy. And I had seen him and his wife the year before, so almost exactly a year. And she had been cheating on him with one of their friends. So we did all the intervention part, and we talked it through, and worked on it. And so then, apparently it was better. I don't know. I had my suspicions. But he contacted me exactly a year later, and wanted to have session, and sure enough, she's been cheating on him the whole time. This man, he looks at me in the middle of this conversation and goes, Christy, how can I learn to trust her again? I just want to go. I have a good deadpan. It's only a few times in my career I've lost it. I just want to go. You don't.